Morning friends, today a very interesting session for those engineers who are preparing for technical interviews. Students, you know very well that there are abundance of interviews which we have to face for a good job. And you must be knowing there are HR sessions which we have already given you abundance of videos based on that. और आज हमारा जो वीडियो बेस्ड है आपके टेक्निकल राउंड के ऊपर और ये वो प्रोबेबल क्वेश्चंस हैं जो पर्टिकुलरली इंजीनियर से बहुत बार पूछे जाते हैं एंड आई बिलीव इफ यू प्रिपेयर दोस क्वेश्चंस वेल दैट वुड बी एन आइसिंग ऑन द केक ऑन योर सिलेक्शन सो लेट अस सी हाउ यू कैन टेक द बेनिफिट आउट ऑफ इट सो आर यू रेडी माय डियर ओके माय टीम इज रेडी ओके सो लेट अस गो ऑन दिस टेक्निकल राउंड माय फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन इज व्हाट इज नेम स्पेस स्टैंडर्ड डिफाइंड फॉर
नेम स्पेस स्टैंडर्ड डिफाइंड फॉर what we have given to the variable.
Okay.
Standard is the particular namespace std.
Right.
Cout, cin and lots of other things are defined in it.
Okay.
Basically namespace is the declarative block.
Okay.
In which is used to store the address of an object and give name scope to the variables.
Okay. But I want your voice to be a little louder so it would be comfortable for our viewers to understand. What happen if we do not use namespace std or standard?
If we do not use namespace std, then for instance, in the place of cout, we use standard scope resolution operator than cout.
And what do you mean by the word static?
The static is the keyword okay. which is used before the variables and functions.
Okay.
Static keywords has the property that they can preserve their value even they are out of scope.
Okay, yes, Alicia. Any question from your side?
And what is object?
Object is an instance of a class.
Okay.
When we define a class, there is no memory given to the class.
Okay.
But when we initialize an object, then memory is given to the object. And object is initialized by given constructor of the class.
And how many types of memory allocation in C?
In C, there are three types of memory allocation.
Okay.
First is static memory allocation. Second is dynamic memory allocation and third is automatic memory allocation.
And what do you mean by the difference between modifier and qualifier?
So modifier and qualifier are two different things.
Okay.
Qualifier is the term which is used before the variables.
Okay.
It means when we want to modify any variable, then we use qualifier. There are two types of qualifier. Quant and const.
Okay.
And modify is the term which is used before the variable to given memory in the memory block.
Okay. See, you must be knowing there is a difference between modifier and qualifier as you very well told. But there is also a difference between macros and constant. Have you heard these words? So would it be possible for you to explain and elaborate just like you have explained as modifier, qualifier. And students, you are watching also that all these questions are based on technical rounds. So to benefit for those engineers who are just pass outs and who want to go in campus placements or other interviews. Yes, macros and constant.
Macro is the keyword which
okay.
is used before the variable.
Okay.
Macro is defined by preprocessor.
Okay.
When we declare any macro, then before we use compiler, macro is used.
Okay.
Macro is faster than constants.
Okay.
But when we define a constant, then the constant keyword is used.
And what is cascading of operators in C++?
When we use multiple use of cout and c in any single statement, this is called cascading of operators.
Okay. And difference between object-oriented language and object-based language.
So object-oriented language is the language which follows all concept of OOPs language.
Okay.
For example, Java language.
Okay.
Whereas object-based language is the language which does not totally follow the OOPs language. For example, JavaScript language.
Okay. Yes, Alicia, any question from your side?
What is the difference between early binding and late binding?
Early binding is the binding which is also called compile time binding.
Okay.
In early binding, compilers know about what we does with the program.
Okay.
In early binding, compiler is directly access to the identifier with the machine address. Whereas in dynamic binding, it is also called runtime binding. In this, compiler does not know what did about the program. It did only with compile time.
And what is abstract class?
Abstract class is the class which is used before. Abstract is the keyword
okay.
which is used before any class name. In abstract class, we cannot define our body.
Okay.
It is only abstract method in abstract class.
And mutable in C++?
So mutable is the storage class specifiers in C++.
Okay.
By the mutable word, we give memory to the memory blocks.
Okay. And what is EOF and FEOF?
So EOF is the end of file.
Okay.
FEOF is the file of end of file.
Okay.
When we use get the function, then it gives. When we at end of file, then it fails of the function, then EOF is used. But when sometimes compiler is confused, either our function is ended or is fails, is due to some reason it fails. So feof is used.
And what is interface in Java?
So interface in Java is the blueprint of a class.
Okay.
In interface in Java, we can use constructors, statics, and abstracts class. Basically, interface in class is used to provide the absenteeism and the multiple inheritance.
That's wonderful. And difference? Yes, please.
Friends, as you know that we have a set of three books. First is 70 Ways of Spoken English.
Yes, please.
Second is Universal Interview. And third is Medical Representative.
Students, you know very well that we are promoting our books. And regarding interviews, we promote karte Universal Book, especially for engineers, because it's GD and PI, and especially in Hindi as well as English. Other than that, if you improve your communication skills, definitely 70 ways is much better for you. But other than that also, we are calling you for the next 7 days over here. Your food accommodation will get arranged. And moreover, if it is unable for you to visit, definitely we will make you prepare regarding telephone preparations also. So my next question to you is, what do you mean difference between entity and attribute?
So entity is the any place or person,
okay,
which is the single person defined.
Okay.
But attribute, which is defined the property of entity.
Okay. And Alicia, any question from your side?
What is the advantage of C++ over C?
The C++ is the slow language than C language.
Okay.
But there are more advantages of C++ language. There are just, for example, C++ has OOPS language.
Okay.
In which there are multiple inheritances which is used to secure data. And C++ is more secure language than C language.
And what is constant pointer? Have you heard this word?
Yes, sir.
Please elaborate.
Basically, pointer is the place where we can store the our variable.
Okay.
And constant pointer is the variable which cannot change the address which it is holding.
And SQL and MySQL.
So SQL is the language.
Okay.
Which is called standard query language.
Okay.
SQL language is used to processing the queries, manipulate, and for deleting any queries.
Okay.
Whereas MySQL is the end database management server, which is used to define any server in MySQL language.
Students, I hope that especially the viewers, those who are interested in engineering line, because see, up to that you are watching our videos, you are getting HR related questions, but this is a technical round. I hope these technical questions would also be fruitful for those who are preparing for such interviews. And what is spaghetti programming?
So spaghetti programming is the programming in
yes.
which when we use many go-to statements, many exceptions,
yes.
threads, and other competitive words,
okay.
then our programming seems to be very hard and it is very hard to understand,
okay.
which is called spaghetti programming.
And what is volatile variable?
Volatile variable is the variable. It's the same as the other variables, but the volatile variable has the property that they can change their value at any point in program.
What do you mean by the word virtual destruction?
So virtual destruction is used to delete and to remove an instance from a class,
okay.
of a base class from the drive class pointer.
Okay. And class and structure difference kya dono mein?
So class and structure basically both are two different things.
Okay.
Class encapsulates both data members and member functions.
Yes.
Whereas structures are only defined for data members.
Okay.
Default access specifiers for class is private, whereas default access specifier for structure is public.
Alicia, it's a good sign that he is speaking good, right?
Yes.
Our viewers are quite happy that now the person has started a lot. And it's a good sign from us that Tanish has started giving a very awesome interviews to you people and he hasn't braked yet. You will see, I will ask abundance of questions and Tanish answers deta jayega. No doubt preparation advance ki bhi hai, practice ki bhi hai. No doubt this is the right thing. Aisa nahi hai ki on the spot chal raha sab kuch. But the thing is, when you prepare in such a manner regarding HR questions, regarding this, no problem at all. People from all India are reaching us for such interviews and they are gaining much more. If you have those guts to develop your communication skills, your body language, your communication skills, you are welcome. And I can promise you that definitely there will be a drastic change in your own personality also. So my next question to you, have you heard the word R value and L value?
Yes.
Please.
So L value is the value which is used left hand side of an assignment operator.
Okay.
Where R value is the value which is used right hand side of an assignment operator. And L value become R value, but R value cannot become an L value.
Okay. And pointer means what?
Pointer is basically a variable which holds the address of another variable.
Okay. And what do you mean by the sequential access file?
Sequential access file is the file which is used to store data in any sequential manner.
Okay.
It means when we store any file or any data, they are stored in any sequential manner.
Okay. Alisha, have you questioned in this pointer means what? Pointer pushing ka dhaarne? Okay, then please tell the word pointer also.
Pointer is the keyword which is used for before any variable.
Okay.
By the use of pointer, we can hold the address of another variable.
Okay. And advantage over C++ over C?
So C++ is the very slow language.
Okay.
But it has many uses. Okay. C++ is more secure language than C language. Also C++ has its concept.
Okay.
So there are many multiple inheritances and very operator overloading and operator overriding functions are used.
And one advantage of C over C++?
So C is the very fast language and C++ language. And there and C has very short runtime which is very used for compilers.
Okay. And difference between overloading and overriding?
So overloading basically a concept.
Okay.
In which two or more than two functions have the same name.
Okay.
But their signatures are different.
Right.
But overriding is the same name of two functions.
Okay.
But their implementations is different.
And what do you mean by the word singleton class?
Singleton class is the class which have the limitations of we can only make one object.
Okay.
We can make singleton class by making this constructor private.
What is string immutability?
String immutability means when we initialize an object of any string, then we cannot change it.
Okay.
If we can change or we can modify an object, then the other object is formed with the modified values.
Okay. What algorithm is used for garbage collection?
For garbage collection, mark and sweep algorithm is used, which is also called sweep and run algorithm.
You are from Mali.
Yes.
Are you satisfied from personality classes?
Yes, sir. Absolutely.
What do you learn from us?
I have learned good communication skills, good personality development and good body language.
Now you feel as if that with these classes you have changed a lot.
Yes sir, I have changed myself.
So the same concern we talk to our viewers also, that if you are ready enough, that all over India people are reaching us. If you go through our previous videos, you will find people are reaching us from south, from all zones I can say, to prepare themselves for a 7 days program. So if you have those guts and want to develop your skills, definitely you are welcome. Difference between error and exception.
So error is a runtime property.
Okay.
It is an irreversible property. By this we cannot change the error concept.
Right.
Whereas exception is the property by this which is the user concept. When the user gives a bad input, then an exception is occurred.
And Java class loader means what?
Java class loader is the loader which loads the Java class file into Java virtual machine.
Alisha, any question?
Sir, what is bit masking?
Bit masking is the concept which is used to separate out the subsets from a set by the bit vector.
And Java equal ignore case works as? How it works?
Java equal ignore case is the function.
Okay.
In this there are two strings.
Okay.
Which is used in this there are two strings and these two strings are compared to each other.
Okay.
by ignoring their equal ignore cases.
Okay. And what is system call? Have you heard this word?
Yes, sir.
Please tell.
System call is the concept in which when we want to access a program or want to sequential access, then the compiler and request to the kernel. Then kernel is replied to this request. This is called system call.
And what are the different class full and class less IP addressing?
So class full IP addressing is the addressing in which there are two types of network.
Okay.
Network ID and host ID. In class full addressing, total network are divided into two parts, network
okay.
ID and host ID.
Yes.
In the same subnet mask is used in whole network. Whereas in classless IP addressing, same subnet mask is not used in the whole IP address.
And can be array declares at runtime? Can it be possible?
Yes, in C++, we can array declare at runtime by the help of pointers.
Okay.
But in Java, as we know, there are no pointers, so we cannot declare at runtime.
It means that Java it is not possible,
yes.
But C++ it is possible.
Yes.
What is meant by high order byte and low order byte?
So low order byte is the byte which holds the least significant bits of an integer.
Okay.
Where high order byte is the byte which holds the high significant bits of an integer.
Can an array have a L value?
No. So array cannot have L value because array is made up of small elements.
Okay.
So we cannot give an L value to an array.
Is default case necessary in switch statement?
No, it is not necessary in this switch statement,
okay.
but we can also given to our help and for logic purpose only.
Can we assess global variable if there is a local variable with some name, same name?
No, in C this is not possible.
Okay.
But in C plus we can possible to give same name as local variable.
What is generic pointer?
So generic pointer is the pointer of an integer which have return type void.
Okay. What is the difference between pointer and generic pointer? What difference here?
Pointer is simple a pointer.
Okay.
Simple a pointer which holds the address of object. But generic pointer is the pointer which return type, which have return type void.
What is the purpose of ftal?
So ftal function is used to count the number of occurrence in file.
Okay.
It means it tells the how many bits we have covered in a file.
And what is the purpose of register keyword?
So register keyword is basically used for the local variables only.
Okay.
By the help of local variables cannot directly store in the memory. So local variables stores in the register keyword. It is faster than memory.
Okay, any question?
What is the use of null character?
So null character, basically null character is used to reach the end of file. When we use character array or string, then we have to reach at the end of file. So we use null character.
Okay.
Basically null character is the last character of any file or any string.
Alicia, any more question?
Why is the Java platform independent?
Java is platform independent because Java is when we compile a Java program, then a bytecode is formed. This bytecode is same for all systems like Linux, Mac or Windows. But when we run this bytecode, then for this running this bytecode and JVM is required. JVM is called Java Virtual Machine in which Java program is run. But this JVM is totally different for all different platforms like Windows and Mac. So this bytecode is platform independent.
Explain far and near pointers in C.
So near pointer is the pointer which is 16 bit pointer.
Okay.
In by the use of near pointer, we cannot store more memory. But the far pointer is the 32-bit pointer, which is used to store the more memory.
Wonderful, yeah. Really appreciable. Yes, given a very superb answer.
Yes.
What about your justification? What do you think? Strengths or weaknesses? What do you think?
Yes,
sir.
He has improved a lot.
Okay.
And he has given the
best answers. Okay, you tried your best. Really, regarding technical round, you are good enough. And what do you think your weakness still having? What do you think?
I'm basically in weak in communication skills.
Okay, you feel as if you need to improve your communication skills. Very right. And these two pages, really, I have brought abundance of questions. And I think that my viewers will be very good questions because these are the questions that are asked maximum interviews. Mein puche jaate hai isme se. And students, if you prepare these questions at least prepare, you will feel that almost 50% of the questions are from these papers. So I hope that these technical rounds will be very, very fruitful for those engineers who want to make their career in this. And my best wishes to you and regards you. कि ये 50 क्वेश्चंस अप्रोक्सीमेटली तुमने बहुत अच्छे से हैंडल किए. रियली इट्स अ मैटर ऑफ प्राइड फॉर अस. थैंक यू.